Welcome everyone. Hope you are able to see my screen and welcome and join us for an insightful webinar where we will delve into the world of architecture using Autodesk Revit, providing a concise overview of utilizing Autodesk Revit software for your architectural design. So to start with, let me introduce myself. I am Dinesh Tiwari. I'm from Mumbai, India, and I'm currently associated as a corporate trainer in Koenig with an experience of more than 10 years. To say about my achievements, I am LTI certified TPMA trainer, also Flutter certified application developer, Microsoft certified Power Automate RPA developer associate, and Bhumi certified associate integration developer. My domain includes working with Power Automate tools like Power Automate, UiPath, programming knowledge of C, C Sharp, Python, Flutter application development for Android, iOS, and architectural tools, structural design tools like AutoCAD, Revit, Navisworks, Inventor, Tekla Structures, and many. So this is me, Dinesh Tiwari here, where we will explore today Autodesk Revit architecture software, which is a powerful BIM software. BIM in the sense, building information modeling software used by many architects and engineers and construction professionals to design, plan, and manage building projects. So it integrates, it integrates various disciplines of building design, which enables users to create a detailed digital representation of a building's in physical and functional characteristics. Okay, so the agenda for today, we'll start with introduction to BIM, where we will learn the fundamentals of BIM, building information modeling, understanding its principles, benefits, and application in the construction and architecture industries. And we will also see how this BIM improves, collaboration, reduces errors, and enhance your project efficiency through the use of this software, Revit. Next, we will start with an introduction to our Revit software, okay? Which is a leading BIM software, you can say, okay, where we will learn about its key features, capabilities, and how it supports the creation and management of digital building models. Okay, so here you will gain an overview of Revit's role in the BIM process and its integration, okay? Third, we will start, as we have introduced Revit, we will see its user interface, okay? Where you will navigate this software, how to navigate this software efficiently. Okay, what are the main components of the interface, such as ribbon, what is property palette, project browser, view control bar. Okay, so we will become familiar with all of these main components of the interface, which is normally here and then used for our building your Revit, any architecture model. And at last, we will start with modeling techniques, like how to start with walls, floors, roof, doors, windows, stairs, scaling. Okay, so we will learn all essential, you can say most of the essential modeling techniques for creating a fundamental building elements in Revit. Okay, where we will practice from where you start. We will start with levels and grids. Okay, then walls, then floors. How to make roof, design various roof styles. Then doors and windows, how can you place and customize your doors and windows. Staircase and railings, okay? So this hands-on will definitely help you to build a comprehensive skill set for developing a detailed and I can say accurate building models in Revit. These are few to mention here in this webinar, but yes, of course, there are many more things that we can do here in the Revit. Okay, so let's start with the very first introduction to BIM. So before I start, please feel free to ask any questions, any queries you have to the chat window that we have. Okay, you can post your question over there. Okay, and I will be happy to answer your question. Okay, so please feel free to post your questions over chat feed. Let's proceed with the very first introduction to beam. Okay, so beam, if I say it is a building information modeling, which is a concept, I can say, and process used to represent the data related to construction and maintenance of a building in an organized manner. Okay, in an organized manner, very important. So in beam concept, a 3D model of a building is designed with all the design informations embedded to related component of the building. Okay, everything related to the building, say architectural part, structural part, MEP part, everything. MEP is nothing but mechanical, electrical, pumping. Okay, so this in beaming or beam concept, a 3D model of building is designed with all of these design informations embedded of that particular building. Okay, for example, if a beam or column is created using beam concept, then all the parameters like material, what should be the size of column, weight, shape, time taken for the construction, cost, and so on are embedded to this beam or column in model, and they can be retrieved whenever required. So beam is not a new thing. Okay, it was started early in 1980s. Okay, but nowadays the software using beam technology are becoming cheaper, and hence the beam software is finding a greater use in common building design application. Okay, this is what is building information model. The point to remember here is it is a software which is designed with all design information embedded to that related component of the building. As I mentioned, an example of a column. Okay, so if I'm talking about beam, you may ask like, why I am talking so much about a beam in a webinar which is on Revit? Okay, this is because Autodesk Revit is a beam software. It is a building information modeling software, as shown in the figure that you see here on my screen. Okay, what you can see that this shows a broad spectrum of function which Revit is capable of doing. So Autodesk Revit is a parametric software, which means everything you create in the software will have a specific parameters so that the same object or the structure can be created in real world. Okay, and one benefit of such parametric software is that you can modify any object of Revit by modifying the related parameters at any time during the design. Okay, so Revit also maintains, you can say, a bidirectional associativity between various objects generated by 3D building model, which means if an object, say door or window, is changed in one view, then that change will propagate in all the connected views, everything. So if you change that in the top view or some elevation, on some level or on the north elevation or south elevation, if you change in any of the view, the change will propagate in all the connected. So this is why I am talking so much about beam in this webinar of Revit, because Autodesk Revit is a beam software. You can see the spectrum shown in the figure on my screen, which Revit is capable of doing. You can make your structural design, you can make your system design, architectural design. You can collaborate, you can do analysis, renderings, you can generate reports and schedules, everything from start to end, everything you can. Okay, so if I say everything, what I mean to say that, everything means what I mean to say that. So as I mentioned, this Revit is a parametric software that where you can start with each and everything. So for example, you can get started, you can set up your project with the help of levels in grid. You can build your model with the help of walls, floor, roof, door, stairs, railing, everything. You can add some tags to your room, okay? Mentioning the room name, the room number, the size of the room, all those informations. You can add some detailings. You can create detailed views to the focus, a specific part of the building. You can create some sections. You can annotate. You can document those things. Once you have done with the annotation and documentation, you can create a sheet with different views. And once that is done, you can move into collaboration, which will enable work sharing to allow multiple users to work on the same project. Okay. And once that is done, finally, you can work with the rendering part. Okay. So you can use this Revit rendering tools to create some realistic images of your model, such as you can adjust lighting, materials, and settings to achieve a desired effect. At last, you can finalize the project. So you will be creating a comprehensive architectural design in Revit, integrating both your 3D modeling and documentation, everything efficiently. Okay, hope this is clear. If any questions, any queries you have, please let me know. Okay, the chat window is open to all. Okay, if you face like any questions, any queries, I'm happy to answer those questions. Okay, let's move ahead. Okay, to the other part of this software. So, understanding all this theory concept, now it's time to start with this software. And the first thing you need to know while learning a software is to understand the various components of the user interface of the software. Okay, this is a very first step. The various component of this Autodesk Revit user interface after opening some sample project are annotated in the figure that you see on my slide. Okay, so various option of the user interface after starting a project is what we are going to discuss next. The very first thing that we are going to discuss is the ribbon, which you see here. So this ribbon is a toolbox below the title bar in which all tools are placed under different tabs. Okay, so if I want to show you that, if this is, see, this is my Revit software, okay? Let me start with some blank new project. So how will I start with my blank new project? I'll just click on new, and in this new, I'll just select the template on which template I want to. So I've made one default template of mine with all settings in that. And then I'll just click on okay, and it will take to my, I can say, the workplace, my playground, where I'm going to make my designs, architectural designs here. Okay. And in this architectural designing, the very first part that I was discussing in this user interface was the ribbon part, which is, you see here on the top of my screen, the ribbon. Okay. So this ribbon is a toolbox just below this title bar. At the very top, you have the title. Okay. And in this ribbon, you will find all the tools are placed under different tabs. All the tools are placed under different tabs. And these tabs are further divided in each panel, which has number of tools. And these tools perform functions of same category. Okay. Say, for example, I have a very first tab is architecture tab. So in this architecture tab, there are various tools like wall, door, window, column. You can create roof, ceiling, floor. You can create curtain walls. You can add mullions, many things related to architecture. Say if you're working as a structural engineer, you can go to the structural tab where you will find all the tools related to structure. We have steel tab, which is again very important when you work with a structural tab. Okay, we have precast. We have systems which normally works with your MEP, mechanical, plumbing, and electrical, all tools related to MEP part. You will find all those tools here. Okay, so this ribbon is a toolbox below the title bar in which the tools are placed under different tabs, and these tabs are further divided into panels, as I've shown here, and each panel has number of tools which perform functions of same category. Okay, next important thing. On the left side of my screen, you can see this property palette. Very, very important. The options in this property palette are used to modify the properties of the component you're going to select from the viewport. Okay, whatever component, say I'm making some wall, and if I want to change the property of wall, like the thickness of wall, height of the wall, material of the wall. Same thing if I'm designing any floor, roof, ceiling, door, window, and I want to change the property of door or window, width, height, thickness, material, wooden, aluminum, whatever, whatever. So all those things, modification appear in this property palette. And in this property palette, there is one more very important. You can see this edit type, which displays the property of family type to which the element belongs. And if I click on this edit type, you will see one window where you can edit the properties of the command that you are putting. Very important palette, properties palette. Okay. I'm just discussing few important palettes here of Revit interface. There are many things. Next important thing is the project browser, which you see here on my left, right hand side of this. And this project browser is basically used to switch between various views, various sheets, and objects in the current Revit project. Okay, so you can see there are various levels, level one, level two, site plan, ceiling plans, we have elevations, we have. Okay, so if you want to switch to any of the levels, ceiling plan, to some elevation, north elevation, all those things you can do with the help of project browser. So basically, it is used to switch between various views, sheets, and objects. I'll show you how we will do that. And then there are various toggle and switch options to change the view of the model available in the view control bar just below the graphic area. You can see these all options. These are the various toggle and switch options that you can use to change the view of the model available in this graphic area. The very important part of the interface, ribbon, properties, palette, and the view control bar, which is at the bottom of the graphic area. And after making all this, there is an option file menu, which you see on the very top left corner, okay, which is used to manage the functions related to files, like opening a file, creating a new file, exporting a file, and so on. Okay, all those options are uploaded here. Okay, so let's get started with this interface as we are going to concentrate on architecture. I'm going to this architecture tab where I will be showing you some of this, some of these tools which you can use for your architectural design. Okay, so let's start with some of the core elements. Starting with levels, grids, then we will move towards walls, floors, roof. And once we are made with this, we will move towards doors and window, how to make stairs and railings, which is very simple. Okay, so let's start doing that. So this is my software. Let me see if I have any questions on the chat window. Okay, there is no. Okay, please feel free to ask any questions, any queries if you have, okay? Okay. So whenever you start with your project, okay, a new project, this is what is the window that you will see, okay? And you will see these four cameras. In between these four cameras, you are going to make your architectural project design, okay? And say if I go to any of these elevations, if I go to north elevation, so whenever I say north elevation, I want to switch to that elevation. That means I will go to project browser window, and from there I will switch. So I'll go to this north elevation, and here you can see that I have two levels, level one and level two here. By default, two levels are created. So in this Revit, levels are nothing, but you can say they are the horizontal planes that acts as a reference for various elements within a building model, such as floors, ceiling, roof, and other structural components. They are crucial for defining the vertical positioning and organization of building design. Okay, so why? What is the application, practical application of this level, if I say in a very simple language? With the help of this level, you can define different floor heights in a multi-story building. Means you can create, say this is a two level, means how much floor it is, you can make a two level building. Okay, you can make 10-story building, 14-story, 20, 40, 50, 100-story building by adding these vertical levels. You can define different floor heights in a multi-story building. Okay, so these levels are a fundamentals in Revit for organizing and managing the vertical aspects of building project, ensuring accuracy and coherency throughout the design and the construction phases. Okay, and if I want to make this level, how I'm going to make this level? Let us understand this. Okay. Yes, there is one question I see from Nikhil. You mean level is a plinth of a building? Yes, this level you can define as a plinth level, as a zeroth level, first floor, second floor, third floor. Yes, Nikhil. So the answer is you might define this level as a plinth level of your building as well. Okay. Okay. So how do you define this level? Let's see how to define this level. To make this level, what I'm going to do here is on the architecture tab, okay, I have under this datum panel, there is one option for grid and one option for level where you can add levels to your model. Okay, so how to add levels? Just click on this level. Okay, so when you click on this level, you can see here on the top, modify, place level, make plan view, plane view types. Okay, where you want to create level, all those details. We will keep those things aside now. As of now, I want to simply create a level. Okay, and I'm going to create that level. Okay, let me create. Let me delete this one level and just delete this default level. Okay, or let it be, I'll just keep this level as it is. You can see the distance between level 1 and level 2 is how much? 10 feet. They are at the height of 10 feet. Okay, so if you want to change your height of the ceiling, you can simply double click. Instead of 10 feet, say I want to make the ceiling height as 13 feet. I'm simply writing 13 feet, 0 inches. You can see from ground floor, my height is now 13 feet. Okay. As Nikhil mentioned, if you want to change the name of the level, instead of level 1, I can make the name of the level as plinth level. Simply, you can type the name as per your project, whatever your work. Okay. I can name this level describing this as a plinth level. That's it. Just click anywhere on the screen. Do you want to rename? Yes, I want to rename. So this is a level which will indicate the plinth level. Okay, after this plinth, say I want to make my zeroth floor foundation, plinth, then first floor, second floor, and so on. So you can also change the name of the level. Say I will start here from zero floor. I'm just writing zero floor. Yes, and rename my second level, which is at 13 feet height, as first floor. Okay, let me add few more levels. Okay, zero floor, first floor. How to add levels? As I mentioned, you have to go to the architecture tab, go to this grids. Okay, say at how much height I want. So I will provide here at the offset distance of 13 feet I want. So I'll just write on the top here 13 feet 0 inches, and from this I'll just select this pick line command. I just click on this pick line and I will just select my grid. So as soon as I select my grid, you can see automatically you can see a half tone or a shaded or a light dotted line. it is showing that is my level. Okay, so if I click on this level, you will see it will add one more level, level 3, which is at a height of 26 feet from my ground floor, 0. Okay, but the distance between first floor and second floor, say I will name this as a second floor. Okay, first floor, but distance between these two is how much? It will be only 13 feet. Okay, so likewise, I can add multiple levels. Okay. How many story building you want to create, that much story you can. And once you have done with this, you can just right click cancel to come out of this car. Okay, so you can see I have created how many levels? 0 level, first floor, second floor. Let me name my level 3, level 4 as third floor, 3 floor. Yes, and here I'll name this as 4. So as soon as you will go adding these levels into your work plane, in this project browser window, you can see automatically those levels are reflected here. 0, first, second, third, fourth. Automatically ceiling plans are created. 0, first, second, third, fourth. The elevations are created. As of now, I am on the north elevation. You can see. You can go to the east elevation. Double click. You will see the east elevation from the east side. How you will see that from the south side, from the west side, whatever you want, you can go to that elevation. And just keep only one elevation open, north elevation, and 0. That's it. Hope everyone is with me. Okay, and you are understanding. Okay, if any questions, any queries, please feel free to ask me. Okay, so I have done with the levels. As I mentioned, these levels define the floor height in a multi-story building. Okay, and these levels are fundamentals in Revit for organizing and managing all the vertical aspects of your building project. Now, once you have done with the level, the next part that comes into picture is the grid. Okay. Say I will go to my 0th floor. How to go to 0th floor? You can just double click here on the project browser. You are in the 0th floor. Okay, and now in this 0th floor, you want to create some architectural drawing. So what are these? How to do? One way to do that is directly you can start constructing your wall here. Okay, but what I will do, I will construct the things with the help of grids, some reference line. Okay, there will be some horizontal and vertical lines. Keeping those horizontal vertical lines in reference with the help of those grids, I will make some drawing. I'll construct a wall. Okay, for that purpose, we use grids. So this grid is used as a reference line to create various construction objects in the model. Okay, and also this grids are is a tool is available just in the architecture tab. You can see just below the level you have this grid. Okay, just click on the grid tool from the datum panel in the ribbon. Okay, as soon as you click on this grid tool, you will see the modify grid placement contextual tab will be displayed in the ribbon, and it will ask you to specify the starting point of the grid. I'm just providing the starting point here, and this is the ending. That's it. Okay, so just one single grid I have made. So you need to just click at the desired location to specify the starting point of the grid line, and similarly to specify the end point of the grid line. Once you have done with this grid, I will create multiple grids here. Okay, and how will I create the multiple grids? Same way as a level. Say I want this grid lines at an offset distance of say 20 feet. So I'll just do an offset here of 20 feet, 0 inches. And I'll just click on pick line and see. I'm just creating multiple grids below this. Okay. That's it. Right click, cancel to come out to escape that command update. So these are my horizontal grids. Say I want to make some vertical grids also. So to make the vertical grids, again, I will go to this grid, okay? And I'll start making one vertical grid, something like this. Let's say, okay? Again, At an offset distance of, say, I want this at an offset distance of 20 only, I will keep 20 feet, 0 inches. Pick up pick lines. I have made this. So basically, these grids are going to act like a reference line, okay, with the help of which I will draw the drawing. Right click, cancel to come out of this command. So this is my zeroth floor. I'm working on my zeroth floor as of now. Okay, so if I change my floor to first floor, my first floor, my second floor, my third floor, fourth floor, you will see all the grid lines on this floor. Okay, as of now, I'm working on which floor? On my zero. Okay, I've made these grid lines on the zero, which is, you can see on the first, second, third. Now, with the help of these grid lines, say I want to create a wall. And the tool to create the walls are available in this wall drop-down of the build panel in the Revit. Okay, you can see under this architecture tab, I have first tool of wall. Okay, and when I expand this, there are different walls. You can create architectural walls, structural walls, wall by face. Okay. What are these architectural walls? These architectural walls are the walls which are created where no, you can say where load is not endured by walls. In such cases, the wall acts as an enclosure for it. Okay. Note that by default, architectural walls do not appear in the structural model. Say if you create structural walls will come with some steel parts inside this. Okay, some load bearings inside that, okay, for creating a wall, internal details and all. So I'm creating a simple, as we are concentrating on architecture. So I'll just go to architectural wall, okay. As soon as I activate my architectural wall, you can see the property palette for that wall is open. Okay. The options related to this wall will be displayed in this property palette. Okay, here you can just select which type of wall you want to make. You want to make 8 inches of wall, or you want to make 8 inches sealed masonry wall, 12 inches wall thickness. Basically, this is nothing but the thickness of the wall. How much thickness of wall you want. Okay, or you want to make some exterior brick CMU wall, what type of wall you want. Say, I will take any type of wall, say, exterior brick on CMU. Okay, this type of. And now with the help of these grid lines that I've made, I will just start my constructing my wall. So this is the start point for the wall. This is the end point for the wall. Again, from there, I'm constructing one wall like this. You can see, and this with the help of these grids will make me draw my drawing easier. So this is what I'm constructing my. Okay. Say in between this, I've done with this wall, cancel, cancel to come out of the command. Okay. And now if I want to see this wall, okay, I will simply go to my view tab. Okay, 3D. You can see on the top, I have default 3D. Just click on that. It will take you to the default 3D view of the wall. And the shaded, let me make this as realistic. You can see the wall, how it is constructed. See the wall part, you can see here. So this is the wall with the help of grid lines I have made here, where on my zero. So I want to add some partitions between this wall. So I don't want for that, I will take a small 8 inches of wall architectural. And let me take some architecture wall here. Some, say I will take 8 inches still. Let me add some partition here. Something like this. It cancel, cancel, and on the 3D view, you can see how I have added partitions inside the walls. Now, whatever thing you want to change related to wall, you can do all those things in the property palette, as I mentioned. Okay, you can change all those scales related to wall under this property palette. Okay, say if you select this wall, okay, for that wall, you will see how the details like base constraint. You can select the desired option from the base constraint. Okay, where the base of the wall will be placed. So my base of the wall is placed on the zeroth floor. Okay, it is placed on this. If you want to make the base at first floor, second floor, you can define those. You can select the different levels from this drop-down. Okay, we have base offset. Okay, you can specify the desired value in the base offset edit box of the offset wall base. Okay, so the wall will be placed at a height of a specified value from the base level. See, if I provide some 1 foot of base offset, so instead of starting from zero, it will start from at a height of 1 foot. Okay, the top constraint, where you want this wall to get connected. I want this top wall to get connected to my first floor, second floor, all those details you can define. Where the wall will be created. Okay, all those things you can make. So this is just a simple wall that I have made here. Okay, let us move ahead. Now, once I have done with the grid, levels, and wall, okay, the next thing that I want to see, you can go to the elevation. And in the elevation, you can see the wall height is 20 feet 0 inches, which is not my height, right? I don't want 20 feet. My height for the ceiling is how much? It is just 13 feet. That means it is crossing my first floor. You have to reduce this height of the wall. Just select that wall. Okay. And I want it to go up to level 1. Just select all the wall and make that up to level 1. So this you can do while constructing itself, so that this wall should go up to first floor only, not above first floor. I'm just making all those changes here. I don't want 20 feet wall, I want only 13 feet wall, that is up to level first. And now if I go to my elevation, you can see it is properly aligned at the 13 feet height, that is from 0 to first. And in the 3D view, I will see the same thing. So I've done with the wall part. Now next, after creating walls, say I want to create floor. Okay, how to create floor? Okay, so the tools to create different types of floors are available in the floor drop-down list, you can see. Okay, we have architectural floor, structural, floor by face, floor. As per our need, we can go to any of this. Just select, we have to select this four. Architectural tool is used to create an architectural floor. Okay, and let us see how to create that. I will just select this floor architectural, going to my zeroth floor. Okay, this is the wall that I have made here. Okay, now with the help of this tool, draw tools which are available here, I am simply making a floor. I'm just selecting this corner to this corner and just tick mark. And now, if I go to 3D view, you can see a floor basement is created. You can see I have created a floor. So the floor architectural tool is used to create an architectural floor. Okay, just you need to click on floor architectural tool from the floor drop down in the build panel of the architecture tab in the Revit. Okay, as soon as you do that, a modify create floor boundary contextual tab will be displayed in the Revit, with the help of which you can create the floor boundary. You can also select the desired walls and create a desired boundary by using the sketching tools in the draw panel of the theater. Okay. If any questions, any queries, okay, please let me know. It works similar to ETABS. Yes, I will say yes. Okay. Now, once you have done with this floor Okay, you can, if you want to change the property of this floor, simply you can select that floor the way I have selected. And in this property palette, you can just change the properties related to the floor. You can also change the thickness of your floor, how much thickness you want. You want to change the material, all those details, you can go to the edit type. Okay, in this edit type, you can further delete or edit your floor. Okay, so I've done with the floor part. Next, let me show you how you create a roof. Okay, so before creating a roof, let me do one thing. Let me show you how do we add doors and windows. Okay, before starting with the roof part, you will see how to come work with the doors and windows. So these doors and windows are created to allow entry and exit through the building. Basically, a door is used to create door at a specified location. You can also create windows at a specified location. For that, you can simply go to the architecture tab. Here I have an option for doors, which will add doors to your building model. Okay, I simply click on doors. Okay, and wherever I want to place, say I want to place my door somewhere here, I'll just place one door here, second door just between these two grids, and third door here. Come out, cancel, escape. Let me go to the 3D view to have a view of the door. You can see the doors are placed. Okay, let me add some windows to my plan. Okay, so again, going to my zeroth floor, next to door here, I have windows, which will add windows to your building model. Okay, let me click on window and say I will place one window here, one window here. So wherever you want, you can place your window. There are different types of windows and doors that you can do in Revit, not only this simple doors and window that I'm showing you here. You can also work with different types of windows and doors. Once done, come out of the command, cancel. In the 3D view, you will see the windows are also placed. You can edit the properties of the door with the same property palette, edit the properties of the window with the help of same options which are there. Okay. Now, once you have done with this, okay, you have done with the doors and windows. Say, I want my levels. I want to see my levels. It is from 0 to 4th floor. I want to create the same pattern everywhere on all the floors. So how will I do that? Okay, I just simply select this, everything. I have an option, copy to clipboard. Copy to clipboard, paste, assign to selected levels. Say I want to paste this at, I'll just select first floor, control, second and third floor. Click OK. Okay, and now if I go to my 3D view, you will see it has created the same level plan everywhere. Okay, so I've made my base design ready, 0th floor, and same thing is copy pasting on each floor. Now, once I've done with this, say I want to next, I want to create some roof, okay, which is very important. There should be some roof, okay. So to work with this roof, okay, the tools to create roof, you will see they are available under this architecture tab, under this roof drop down. Okay, there are different tools, different types of roof that you can create here. Okay, we will see the very first option, creating roof by footprint. Okay, so the roof by footprint tool is basically used to create a roof by selecting boundary elements like walls. What are the boundary elements here in our case? They are the walls. So with the help of this, you can create your roof thing. Just note that you can also use a closed loop sketch to define a boundary of it. Okay, so let us create a roof for this. In order to create a room, I'll just go and activate my room by footprint. Okay. So the lowest level is the first floor. At what level? I want to create the room at fourth floor. Just click yes. Okay. Clicking yes, I'll go to the ceiling plan of fourth floor. Okay. This is the ceiling plan of my fourth floor. You can see here. Okay. Or you can simply go to the floor plan of the fourth floor. Anywhere, or you can simply work on the 3D part where you can use this draw command. Okay, you can use this draw command, and there's a rectangle command here, and I'll just select this corner to this corner somewhere in here and just click. Okay, and this is the roof I have created. You can see here, you can simply move this to see the structure of your. This is some inclined roof that I have made here. Okay, you can make flat roof also, whatever type. There are different types of roof that you can make here. I have made a simple roof. Just come out of the command, simply click cancel, cancel, so that you are out of this command. Okay. Next, the stairs part. Let me show you if you want to create stairs. So we have seen different components like wall, door, window, components, column. Column is also very interesting part. Okay, roof, ceilings, floor. Let me show this stairs. Nikhil is asking for stairs. Okay, so let me go to the zeroth floor. And at this zeroth floor, say I want to put some stairs here. Say I'll just activate this stair command. Okay. And say you have to provide some I'll just put some random point for the stairs here, but yes, keep in mind you have to use some proper as per your designing dimensions. You have to place that as per your dimension. I'm just taking this randomly from here. I want That's it. And now if on the 3D view, if I see that, you can see how I have added the stairs. Okay, so there are different, you can also work with the stairs. You can also add railings. Say if I want to add railings here, say I can go to this railings, sketch path. You can just sketch the path with the help of this draw tool, which is there here. With the help of this line tool, say I want to start my railing at this point. Or let me go to the floor level. I want to start railing at this point. From here to here. Right click cancel to come out of the command. Okay. Now, if I go to the 3D view, see, I was able to add railings. Okay, so you can add roof, railings, stairs, you can add ramp, many, many, many things you can work here. Okay, so we have seen just some of them here. Okay, we have seen some of the core elements, levels, how to levels, grids, walls, floor, roof, door, windows, stairs, and railings. Okay, so just a quick summary on the different things that we have seen. We have started with the BIM software, okay, where I explained you what is this building information modeling, which is nothing but a digital representation of a building, you can say, building's physical and functional characteristics, which will help enable architects and engineers and construction professionals to work on their drawings. Okay, then after this, we have understood our Revit software, okay, which is one of the leading BIM software that supports multidisciplinary design process for architecture, engineering, and construction. We have only seen the architecture part. You can do the structural part, you can do mechanical part, you can do electrical part, you can do plumbing part, everything. It is a multidisciplinary design process software. Okay, so this Revit provides tools for 3D modeling. After creating drawing, you can make documentation, you can do analysis, everything. Once With this, next we have seen the user interface, which is designed how to navigate and make your workflow more efficient. We have seen some of the key elements, including ribbon, what is project browser, what is property palette, the view control bar. Okay, we have seen all those things. And then we started with some of the basic modeling techniques, like different things, like we have seen levels and grids, where level define different floor height and are essential for vertical planning. And we also seen grids, which provide a framework for placing structural and architectural elements. And then in this basic modeling, further we also seen the working with walls. Okay, how to create a wall, floors, and roof. And these walls can be easily drawn and adjusted in a 2D and 3D views. We have seen the floor part, which are created by defining the boundaries, while roofs can be modeled with various shapes and slopes. I've shown you slope roof. Okay, you can make various type of different shapes of roof that you want. So this element forms the foundation of building model. Next, we have seen doors and windows also, how to add doors and windows in the Revit. Not, I've shown you just one type of door and window. There are another more type of doors besides different designs of doors and windows that you can add here. You can do detailing. You can make the functionality of door and window as per your requirement. And these elements are inserted into the wall components and can be customized with different styles, sizes, materials, everything, which will fit your design requirements. Okay. Next, we have seen stairs and railing. Okay. Which provides tool for creating stairs and rail, accommodating various design configurations. Now here, the stairs can be any type. It can be a straight stair, it can be a spiral stair, or some custom shaped stair, okay, that you can make here with some adjustable dimensions and materials. Okay, then we have also seen the railings, which can add a safety for your building model that you have made. And these railings can be agreed of any design. It can be a glass railing, it can be a steel railing, any type of railing. Different designs are available. Okay. This all I can say it's summarized, and it provides a concise overview of each thing, each topic that we have seen today, capturing the essential aspects without delving too much in detail. I didn't go too much in detail. I just showed you what is this Revit is capable of doing. That is what is our seminar, a short guide to Revit architecture. Okay, without delving too much into the detail. Okay, so let me know if you have any questions on queries for the thing software that we have seen. Can you compare Revit tools with Stat Pro, ANSYS, and DE tabs? Okay, so Nikhil, for the comparison of this Revit tool with Stat Pro, ANSYS, and tab, I will say you can focus on their primary uses, trend, and differences in context of architecture, engineering, and construction. As I mentioned, Revit primary use is the building information modeling. That is what is the strength. It is an integrated design which integrates architecture, structure engineering, and MEP design. Okay. And this is the major strength of Revit. Where areas STAD Pro, okay, its primary use is only for structural analysis and design. ANSYS is only for finite element analysis design, you can say. And this ETAB uses a building analysis and design, okay, which is optimized for analysis and design of building systems. Okay, this is what. So in summary, I can say Revit itself is everything of all. It's a everything in one. So each tool serves different purposes within your industry. Okay. Revit being the most comprehensive tool, I can say, with other tools that you mentioned. It is the most comprehensive. design works on code, what code is set in default in Revit? Does this design work on code, and what code is set on Revit? So this Revit, in Revit, the concept of code, I will say, refers to the building standards and regulations that must be adhered to in architectural and engineering design. So Revit itself does not enforce a specific building code by default. Instead, it provides it tools and features that allows designers to ensure their model comply with relevant building codes and standards applicable to their project. Okay, so this is what I would like to say you. Say, for example, if you're working on a project in some country like United States, and you might configure your Revit template and families to comply with the IBC. Okay, so by setting up your project correctly from beginning and using Revit robust parametric scheduling tools, you can ensure that your design meets the necessary building codes, okay, and standards, not any specific coding.